ating mga proponents dito may mga nasubmit na although many of them are still to be subjected for quality assurance. So wala pa. So that's why in the soft opening, don't be surprised if Sir Julius will only provide us 4 or 5 or even less than the number of tools you expect, no? Because there are processes that have to be done, no? Meticulously before they are rolled out. So yung document review naman, every time you ask a program owner or proponent to submit a report, and then based on the report, you look at it, that is what we call document review. You evaluate performance based on the report submitted, no? Whether database siya or descriptive, it doesn't matter, basta kay document review. So as a school head, you can anytime ask, you know, a report from your moderator or coordinator, and then when you ask the report, you take a copy of it for office file or for electronic version of it to be kept. Then and then a parcel of data or information is taken for your consideration sa imong action or sa imong decision. Then that's basically doing that document review, no? Document review. So yun po yung document review na ran. The rest are being monitored using tool, no? Ang tool dito is more generic siya kaysa sa checklist. A checklist is just one type of tool, no? If I'm not mistaken. Then these are the rest of the activities or parts being covered by the division performance evaluation plan, no? And so this mechanism, which was presented in one of the exicoms, but for the purpose of this launching, it is being given to you again for the purpose of benchmarking, for the purpose of showing to you that we have already established the system since June 8, 2020, and we try to keep it as something that is active, something that is applicable up to this time and even in the future. No? Ang mag-change lang ang performance evaluation plan. So this is our mechanism, what, among the provisions that can be gleaned there, can be read. And I'm going to go further into this part, no? This part, the preparation of tools. Again, at the school level, at the district level, I know, no? I have learned from our supervisors, from Mang Lilia, that you have a lot of tools also at your level, no? Being developed and being used to monitor performance or to monitor the implementation of the program. You are in the right track in that direction. Maybe you lack some steps, but that's a good practice, no? That's a good practice of coming up with a contextualized tool, especially so if this tool is being communicated beforehand by the proponent para aware po siya, and then ang kulang na lang ang other steps to make sure that the tool is really measuring, no? The things that are covered, the things that are taken by the program, no? By the concept, by the program. So let me focus right away on the diagram. So it is the responsibility of the program owner to prepare the tool. That's given. That's given. And then if you have the SMME coordinator or the school MME coordinator, ang iyang function is to provide, no? Provide assistance. Unless the SMME or MME coordinator of the school volunteers to prepare the tool for your school level program, no? So sa mga program naman na masabi natin na built in na, no, it is there, division kung siya, division level program siya or even CO level program na siya, so wala na kayong problema, hindi na kayo maghanap ng tool, no? In fact, many of these tools are applicable to you, even if they are administered by nurse or by SDO personnel or by school head. But I guess the intent is to also make it available to you, no? The data gathered in the system. And then when there is a tool, of course, it has to undergo quality assurance. And a QA team or a QA committee has to be formed, at least at division level, meron na to quality assure the tool. And then in quality assuring the tool, there has to be a quality tool, quality assurance tool to that effect. No? And we come up to that, we have that, and then I will share it to you for you to also benchmark if you want to establish this thing, no? In preparation for the requirement later on of the Panagyod, no? Unstoppable implementation of QMS at all level, levels, no? Ang atuan na lamang good ito, good, balik ka ng QMS, kana na lamang good kung make available na sa central office ang money, no? From their gas, if I'm not mistaken, na dito paon ang amount for the outsourcing for the procurement of third party certifying body, no? Third party certifying body. The superintendent, or in your case, the principal for approval. And then, once approved, if you want it to be implemented, to be utilized efficiently, effectively, then have an electronic version of it. No? Make use of the skill of your ICT to make it possible. Yun po. Second part is in the administration of the tool. It is important that the proponent would orient, no? The one who will monitor, or the persons to monitor, orient them, no? In a pre-monitoring orientation, and then after that, monitoring. So karon uso na maginang na ang paperless monitoring, although indispensable sometimes that we note, no? We have the paper and pencil monitoring report, indispensable na even as maglagit me, especially in areas where the online, no? Mechanism online M&E cannot be done. So nagina, but if we want to do it faster as far as consolidation, we go to the electronic one, no? Version. And then after the actual monitoring, it is again the duty of the proponent to do the consolidation, unless your SMME will volunteer to help, no? Consolidate the report, or even your ICT, they having the skill, no, to gather the data using the system. And then it is now the SMME will provide technical assistance, no, of the report that you are going to generate. Na lang po. Then the third is report preparation and submission. So it is our commitment that within 3 days from the conduct of the monitoring, the proponent is expected, no, to render his or her report, no, to the program, to the EXICOM, no, to the EXICOM. And it is encouraged that the report is really data-based, no, evidence-based. So wala tay prescribe na template sa report, no, sa report making or sa report. Wala tayo template dyan. Importante is the body of the report, no? The substance. So that's the commitment. So that if we are going to do that in this way, no? So sa ating diagram, ang mangyari is ang program owner will render the report, and then the SMME to validate the report, and then it will be countersigned, or it will be confirmed by the immediate head, or in our case, our chief, and then eventually to our OSDS or SDS for approval, no? For approval. So yun po ang simple na system. Hindi siya actually strange or foreign to you, no? Hindi siya foreign, it's common. Only it is important that it is written. It is written, because in the QMS, one of the policies, one of the credos, no? One of the principles that have to be observed is whatever you write, you do it, and whatever you do, you write it. No? Do what you write what you do. Yun po ang principle, and that I think everybody is already aware. No? Do what you write what you do. Para hindi tayo mamumblema sa ating QMS, no? Especially during audit. And then once signed or once noted, ang responsibility ng ngayon ng proponent is to provide the following offices copy for their consumption also, no? Sa planning, for data banking, and for action research consideration, for SMME, for reference also, whatever, every time they are asked of the status report or the monitoring report, no? Under the program, under the performance evaluation plan, it is required, no? Na mabigyan ang SMME ng report. This is the QA tool that we share to you. I'm sure some of you, if not many of you, are interested also to get smart. No? Ito po yung nasabi natin last time during the demand ko at MIBANG na it is a challenge accepted. Nagagawa tayo ng quality assurance tool to quality assure the tool. So ito na po yun. I will not anymore read one item after the other. This is not perfect. This will undergo modification as time goes by also, but as of this time, since it is already, no, it is virtually approved by our SDS, then this will be our tool used by the QA team to QA, no? Then may note diyan sa baba. But if ever you are interested, we will make this available, and then maybe through our secretariat, our slide can also be shared to you if you wish to have, no, the substance of our report or presentation this afternoon be benchmark. So I think that's all for my part. Thank you very much. Again, once again, quality afternoon. Enjoy.
Thank you, sir. Indeed. Before we proceed to our next discussion, we would like to acknowledge the presence, as well as to give her to give us an inspirational message. The Chief of Human Resource Development Division from Regional Office, Dr. Marietta Anhao. Ma'am, good afternoon.
Hello.
I'm here. Thank you for joining.
So thank you so much. Thank you so much. On behalf of our regional director, I would like to express my thanks, my gratitude to the... Hello?
Okay.
Can you hear my voice, Dr. Dr. Simpson? Hello?
Okay na, ma'am.
Okay, Raba, can you hear my voice? Ma'am Mary?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay lang bang signal dito sa regional office? Can you hear me? Okay, thank you. Yes, ma'am. Okay, on behalf of our regional director, I would like to take this opportunity in advance to say thank you so much to SDS Dr. Lisa Tabilon, to ESDS Judith Romaguera, and ESDS Ma'am Rodeline Ramos for the invite. Thank you so much. No, thank you so much, po. I am so happy because at last you were able to have this electronic performance evaluation, electronic monitoring and performance evaluation mechanism tool. So congratulations to the prime mover on this, a unique innovation. So this is very important, because if you're applying for the ISO accreditation, I know that Melissa is doing her best with the assistance of our two ASDSS and our supervisor. For you to be accredited, for you to be ISO accredited. Congratulations to me, from Judith, from Ramos. I know that a good performance management system works towards the improvement of the overall organizational performance, managing the performances of teams, for ensuring the achievement of the overall organizational ambitions and goals. Yan po ang main reason why you are doing your best for your division to be accredited with IT. Because an effective performance management system plays a very crucial role in managing the performance of the personnel. So, congratulations sa mga the North Division. It is my fervent hope na sana before the second semester, ayos na po tayo. So, we will do our best. We will work hand in hand for the betterment of our clientele, our young learners, our young students. Na sana po, amidst this COVID-19, hindi po hadlang si COVID in preparation for the ISO accreditation. So, to our supervisors, thank you so much for your cooperation, for your more than 100% support to the different programs, different activities of our DepEd officials, especially our SDS, Ma'am Lisa Tabilon. Na sana po, tuloy-tuloy na po ito. It's a long journey, but I know that we can make it with God's guidance and protection. So to one and all, thank you so much. God bless and keep safe always. Thank you for the time. Thank you for giving me the time to pour out our words of thanks to the superintendent of Zamora North Division. Thank you, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. God bless.
Okay, thank you so much, Dr. Marietta Anao. This time, I'd like to remind everyone to kindly mute your microphone to avoid disturbance. And if you have any question, kindly type in your questions in the chat box or comment box. Because later on, the secretariat will entertain your questions. This time, to present the document tracking system and the electronic M&E system, our Division Information Technology Officer, Sir Julius O. Belagantol. Sir?
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. Allow me to present my screen. So I will now present the document tracking system. No, so as part of this the system, no, there are some policy recommendation. No, na implement na to when we implement the system na sa atong sa field na. No, so field personnel are must register the documents intended to be submitted to the SDO in the document tracking system and shall provide description of its content. So sa flow ani niya, so sa field office palang gikan, before maabot ang mga documents na isubmit diri sa division office, it must be encoded first in the document tracking system, in the system. So this will itong minimize, no, katibitong mga problem na to nga na-encounter before nga maglisod tag track asa na ang document atong ipang submit sa division office. With this system, matrack na to kung asa na siya. So but first, before na siya maabot sa opisina sa division office, ato siyang i-encode sa ato ang system. All documents documents submitted to the SDO shall bear the tracking number provided by the system, no? It must be posted in the cover page. So again, pag-abot sa division office, naana tong document, no? Naana siya tracking number. So murabag katong gamit na tong mga ng GNT, LDC, no, na tracking number wherein we can track the location of the documents. So upon receipt of the documents, no, sa atong records section, sa atong records unit sa atong division office, so the officer, no, will electronically receive the documents through the system. So pag-receive niya sa document, so kamo po nga nag-submit the document, you can track the document kung asan oy na-submit na dahil sa na-receive na sa record section. for example, no, division clearance. So inyo man ipaagi sa inyong school head, and then school head agi pa ba nag district, no? So may balaan ninyo kung abot sa division, may balaan ninyo ang inyong document agi submit na abot na ba sa division office, kay matrack man ninyo through the system. So this also includes date and time. So may balaan ninyo, uy, dugay naman akong document karon pa man abot sa division office. Track na ninyo, mapangita, ma'am, katong gadala sa document, piliin nyo mapaningla na kung nasa na. No? So, kung mahimo, tanong jud, no? But this will be a policy naman. So, abot ang kuan nga, dili sa dawaton sa division office kung wala na yung kanyang tracking number, no? Anak na gadya. So, the routing of the documents, no? Shall also be electronically received, no? By the concerned SD official. For example, after sa record section ma-receive, if that paper will be kuan, kanang submitted to the, for example, sa personnel section or sa office of the superintendent for signature, so the in-charge na pod katong sa on that office, like example sa office of superintendent, iyan na pod nang i-receive na electronically ng document. So, matrack na po na to, uy, this particular date and time, na-receive na day sa office SDS ang ako ang document, tutuan na dito. And the also the officer of that particular office can also put some remarks, no? For example, for signature na, or if ever na yung mga kulang sa document, for example, a salary claim, pag-abot sa payroll section, the in charge of the payroll section sa checking, for example, na yung mga kulang-kulang sa mga documents, so makwili siya makaput og remarks dito, and then nga lacking ani particular nga document. So ikaw mismo po sa field, ano na dugay man akong sweldo, ano dugay naman ta akong submit ang document. So makita mo ay nay remarks diri, oh, na kulang day og form 7 or unsa nga form kulang nga attachment. So dali na ang pag follow up, dili na kinahanglan manawag pa mo kun naunsa na. And then pwede pud mo makontak, oy, kani akong document dugay ang kanyang opisina, pa man nila ma-action eh. So, pili na, sign na to pag call sa attention sa itong concern office kung asa na natulog ang imuhang dokumento, wala pa ma-action eh. So, dali na siya. No? So, the system can be accessed through online, kamong mga client, kamong mga field personnel in our website. No? So, atong website, dpdzin.net, under siya sa links nga tab, no? Na diha ni pa hover niyo sa mouse sa links nga tab, na diha document tracking system. I-click na ninyo, and then you will be redirected to this page, no? Document tracking system. Na duha ka button diha, track and trace, and then create tracking code. So track and trace, kung naanam mo'y nasubmit sa division office and dinanam mo'y tracking code, just enter the tracking code sa anang text box, anang text box, and click on search. So makita din nato kung asa na ang document, no? Kung sa status niya. And also, there is a create tracking code. For example, na kay isubmit rin sa division office na document and wala pa siya tracking code. So ikaw na mismo dre mag-create tracking. Click niyo yung button to create a tracking code, no? So after clicking that button, another form will appear wherein you will be asked to select a document type, your name or name in the document, no? For example, katong i-submit ng mga document, kung sato siya ka bunch, sa ka folder, and then daghan tong mga solo dito. So, example, salary claim to siya for teachers in that particular school. So pwede mo tang ngalan diri sa name, sample Juan de la Cruz et al, no? Na then email address, so kaning email address i-type dirang email address sa submit sa document, unsa nga purpose, no? Para nga ang purpose ani para ma-notify ka if ever na movement sa imong document, no? And then also you will receive sa imong email dito pa mo receive katong tracking code, no? Aside from tracking code nga imong ma print after masaks successful imong pag-fill up aning form, you can also receive an email, no, containing the tracking code. And if ever na movement sa imong document within the office, So you will also notify, no? You will also be notified through your email address. And description, so butang description sa boss, this is a salary claim for the month of October to November. Nana ba, panalitan lang, no? Kung bisa kung sang description lang, no? That describes the document na imo ang i-submit. And then sa lower part, na danay kaning captcha. So this captcha ni code mo automatically sa mo change, no? Every open mo ning form deserves as security, no? Kanang kopya on nimo nga number, i-type nimo sa text box and then click on the submit button. At salamat sa comment. Klaro ko na kung tingog daw. No? Thank you sa microphone. This captcha code, no, kanang ang purpose na niya para dili bisikin sa mag-submit bitaw. At least malangan po siya ba? Mara bitaw, gantong bitaw. I'm not a robot, ano ba? To prove that we are human, yun, no? Ang mga purpose, ana. And then, after that, mapilapan na itong form tanan, kaninga form, mapilapan na to, and then, successful na ang pag-fill up, kompleto tanan, a tracking slip will be generated kani siya. So, kaning tracking slip, nag-bear siya tracking code, na siya barcode, then ay document type, then ay sample sa, ang sample ako diha, type, clearance, ang ngalan, ako ang ngalan, and then description, for my retirement, sa ngalita lang, no? Then, and then tracking code. Kana na siya itong i-print na yun, itong i-paste or i-staple dito, sa atong folder nga i-submit sa division office. Again, we can submit kung tinagsa usa lang ka, for example division clearance, usar mo gina siya, no? Or salary claim pwedeng in bunch kung bunch siya, so Julius Pilagantol et al nana lang, no? Mitso to pinakaunang ngalan dito sa ato ang document na i-submit. Kay lisod na pag i-type na. Pwede mag-i-type tanan pero hago na pod kayo, no? So pwede ra usa. Sa description na ta magdaog dayo, no? Yung sa description yung ibutang nimo. So, nanay button da nga print, pag-click yung print, i-ma-print na sila yun natin ninyo ang document, ang tracking slip. Pwede picture ninyo for your kuan, future nga ka ng reference, no? Kaya sige, lang, sige itong tracking code ato nga kuan. So, i-take note na nyo na kuan, tracking code, picture ninyo. But, aside from that, sa inyong email, gani ha, kaninga form, naman to email address ang i-fill up, kasi ipon mo ano yung tracking slip, no? So, di alam mo matigulaan. So, muna importante po itong email address nga ibutang dito. So, that's all for the document tracking system. Sa division office, nakahuman naman Minilag Orient, no? On how to do the routing of the documents in the division office. So, separate po doon siya na mga orientation. But we will have another orientation for that para for this full implementation, no, sa tong document tracking system. Expect na after this one, there will be a memorandum, no, mga stating the policies, guidelines on the document tracking system. Katong gipakita na ganiha nga mga recommended policies lang siya, no, para magamit na to, no, for this system. Now let's move on to the electronic e-money system. So this electronic e-money system can be accessed through deeped.net/reports. This is one system, no? Capable siya mo receive san unsa nga mga reports like atong gi-discuss ni Sir Inding ganiha nga the monitoring tool lagi pa siya sa QA and then QA to approval and then for electronic for preparation kana electronic tool na dayon, so mo ni siya gi-apply diri na siya magamit kani ato ang electronic e-money system. So all mga monitoring tool or mga reporting tool na ni-pass na sa QA, so pwede na diri himuan na rin na mo sa among office o kaning electronic version para sa kaning online reporting system. So that electronic e-money system can be accessed to deeped.net/reports. So sa field, ang inyong trabaho ani, dali ra, no? Igura mo open ani nga link and then download the template atong nga tool and then fill up and then upload. Nana ra kadali ang inyong trabaho. Sa amo adri po sa division office, is kuan ra no mag harvest ato mga reports sa inyong gi submit and then yeah, automatic mo consolidate mo to siya ayon i consolidate ang data dito sa iman ni and then unsa na nila no for policy baka policy making depende sa result sa report nga i-gather. So to access this system, this requires your DPD email or your PTS account. So link man siya sa tuwang personal tracking system. So para ma-authenticate mo, para makalagin mo sa system. No? And this utilize no the Microsoft Excel template para in the accomplishment of the monitoring tool, dali ra nyo pag-uan, dali na kinahalagin pag-online pa mo. So Excel template lang inyo ang inkuran and then para offline ra and then i-submit niyo sa system ahead ra mag-online no and yun siya. So I will now show to you the ani ato online reporting system. So upon logging into that link dependency.net/reports, so you will be asked to log in kani siya. So as you can see, you can sign in using your PTS account or your DPD email. So tanan ra pong DPD email nga na-register sa tong PTS account, mao ra poy ang maka-log in diri, no? So sign in using DPD email for example ako. Ana. Then you will be asked to select a report to submit, no? For now, napatay mga upat pa ka report ato ang ma-submit diri kay some of the tool ipang QA pa to siya, kani pa man ang mga tool ang na QA. Kaning ATAF 1 ATAF 2 4 5 and 6, no? Wala na include ang ATAF 1 ug ATAF 2 ug ATAF 3 kay prepareha ra man to siya gisulod aning ATAF 2. Pero kung kaning ATAF 2 atong i-submit, automatic maka-generate na po may ATAF 3 diri. So sa inyong level, you will accomplish the ATAF 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pero ang inyong i-submit is only the ATAF 2, 4, 5, and 6, no? So ang mga template ana na po diri sa babaw, you can download the template, no? Diri. Para mag-submit mo. For example, in ATAF 5, click lang niyo and then automatic ma-download ng Excel file. Pa. Kani. Click enable editing. So this is now the assessment and technical assistance form 5. Assistance provided to teachers, no? To be accomplished by department heads and master teachers. So type and district, the name of the school, learning area na tabutang na tanan diri. School ID and then the quarter. Ang quarter drop down po siya, no? Na yung mga option, na yung mga box diyan nga kinahanglan i-type niyo ang option and then apoy mga boxes nga kinahanglan na siya drop down. You will select from the drop down, no? And then school ID type na to and then the quarter, so nga quarter 1 to 4 ba, no? Dayon diri sa grade level drop down lang gihapon siya. So for example, kani si master teacher, no, nag-submission report, grade 1, sa issues and concerns na encounter is fail to adjust the level of content / task. So nana. So ang iyang intervention, also a drop down man. So give rewards and recognition, one-on-one mentoring, information dissemination, revisiting the PPST. So if wala diri ang iyang intervention, i-click niya ang others, no? Pag-click niya sa others, puti ning sa ubos, i-type niya ang iyang intervention na gihimo di ana, no? And then kung na-share remarks, so butang remarks di ana, no? So sa grade 2, so this can be used, no, for pila ka grade level daghan, no? So kung dili ko makompleto diri ang imong i-fill up, kung daghan pa kang mga i-answer, so you can use another form, ATAP 5 ra gihapon nga form para ma-submit nimo. Kung example dili masigo diri ang imong mga answers tanan, no? You can use another file na po, download na po bagong form and then fill upan ninyo. So sample sa grade 2 or grade 1 lang gihapon, no? You have another issues and concerns sa grade 1, ana, sa grade 1 lang gihapon. And then another issues nga imong nakuan, less activities provided, and then imong intervention nimo. So some give brief on someone, one on mentoring, revisiting the PPST ana, no? And then ana lang kung others automatic mo puti ning lalong fill up diha unsay others nimo nga other intervention nga imong gi perform, then remarks, and remarks podre. After that, save the form, no? So imong ana to ang katong gi accomplish atong form is at top 5, no? So dire sa pagpa-save na, balik adre sa ato ang katong DepEdZin.net slash reports, and then please select a report to submit. So at top 5, no? And then click on next. So subject, submit, assessment, ating assistant form 5. Then choose file. So pangitaom tong file nga imuhang at top 5. And then click on submit. So dili na ko i-submit kay masapawan tong dito, no? So click submit, then you will be notified kung successful ba imuhang pag-submit of delay, no? So again, download lang sa template dire, and then select a report to submit, and that's all, no? Dali ra. This user ending system nga work in progress pa rin siya, no? So from time to time naay madugang dire nga mga forms, no? And then this kaning interface ano niya, maybe ma-change ang naong ano niya, pero but the process is still the same. You can download the template, you can select the report to submit, and then fill up the form and submit after filling it up, no? Nana lang, mga the same lang sa mga process. Dili na, dili ta pwede maka-submit din na question, no? Pwede ba daw maka-submit o sila-sila na maghimo silang template, like nana may ko nakita diha nga mga sa nagpost na ko, no, sa Facebook nga nanay naghimog mga atap form nga katong electronic na siya, no. Pwede ba to siya nga form i-submit dire katong mga form nga nahimo niyo diha? So dili to siya pwede, no, kay naa siya security feature kani nga form akong gibutang nga only this form nga downloaded dire sa ato ang website mora po ihang dawaton dire sa ato ang system. For example, magbuhat ang form, so dili siya pwede, no? Kung atap 2 imong gamiton, dayon atap 2, and then imong select diri atap 5, dili gyapon siya dawaton. So na siya'y security kay kani siya nga mga fields diri kaning ipilapan ninyo, naman siya corresponding pun nga mga fields dito sa amo ang database nga sublanan ninyo nag-submit ninyo. So nana dili bisag unsa nga form ang magawaton niya. So I think, no, that's all for my presentation of the system, no, for the document tracking system and the electronic M&E tool. Again, this is tool is a work in progress. So daghan pa ni siyang madugang diri mga form, and maybe ang iyang user interface pa change pa. Thank you very much for listening, and good afternoon, everyone.
Sir Jules, hang on for the question and answer.
Sige, go ahead.
Okay, so, thank you, Sir Julius. So this time, let's have now the open forum for your questions. I'd like to hand this platform to our secretariat, Ms. Jacabel Velarde.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. And now we are down to our open forum for this convergence. And as of this moment, we have 3 questions here. So first, this is for Sir Julius from Sir Will Van Grijaldo. Good afternoon, Sir Julius. As long if, do we need to encode the document or the file or pictures of file or scanned lang, then he uploads the system, or just the process of receipt only, not the document? Thanks. So need join og transmittal para sa iyon pag record, sir.
Okay, thank you very much sa question, no. Maybe she's or he's referring to the document tracking system, no. For the document tracking system, the purpose of this system is para matrack lang nato ang atong gisubmit nga document sa division office. Like sa LBC, di ba? Kung magpadala ka sa LBC, ang input niya, ang information lang sa parcel nga imo ang gi-submit. Not the content of the parcel. Dili na kailang i-scan patong parcel or kung sa paano. The information lang of the parcel nga imong gipadala. Nanara. So, katurang mga file, katong ipakita ganihan nga mga form, fill up nimo, the type of the document, the katong ngalan nimo, the email address, and the description. Wala nilain. Pero katong transmittal, of course, nagli transmittal. Kaya katong transmittal, pirmahan man to siya, di ba? So, katong the usual nga process na itong transmittal, naragyapon to siya. Thank you.
So, next question, sir, from Jerry School. Tracking slip, ipadala ni siya sa document nga isubmit sa division office.
Okay, oh, very good, no? Again, katong ganun akong ingon, yes, ipadalagi siya, part siya sa document nga isubmit, ang katong tracking slip. So, pwede mag, duha ko kopya inyo, hanapin inyo, hanapin ipadala ninyo. Okay, katong tracking slip, pag-abot sa division office, pag-abot sa record section, igo lang mo ito siyang i-scan sa barcode, di ba? Damo tayo barcode. Igo lang ito siyang i-scan sa record section, automatic siya, ma-receive sa itong record section. Murag logbook ba? Instead, kanisya murag man siya, gugan na bitang replacement sa logbook sa una, nagabot sa record section, ilogbook kung sa inyong gisubmit na papel, markahag receive. Pero dili na, no? Pag-abot sa record section, pusilong ra itong utan ra ito ang barcode reader. So, mura na siya nalogbook po sa record section nga, na-receive na. Thank you.
Thank you, Sir Jules. And another question from Sir Isao Jr. Kairas. Good PM, sir. How about returning of documents to the sender? Naa na siya nga feature sa tracking? Thank you.
Well, thank you, no? Naa siya sa tracking. Makita nyo dito, the policy of the division office, all documents coming from the field, coming in, then out sa ato ang office, sa division office, will pass through the record section. For example, naisubmit nga papel, muagi sa records, pagawas po sa papel, kay balik sa field, muagi gapon sa record section. So makita dito sa i-track nyo sa document, release by the record section, dayon, release siya. So, meaning, kung na-release siya, padulong siya. For example, clearance, no? The division clearance. So, na-release sa record section. So, maybe nagpadulong na sa inyong district, sa inyong school ba? Ikuha na sa inyong liaison officer ba ninyo? Nana.
Sir Jewel, another question from Sir Wilven Grijaldo again. No, this is not a question they favor Almer na ngayon siya ang answer. Ma'am Mary, can we ask for the forms na to atak nga maura dawatan sa system? Thanks. Thanks sa iyo, Sir Jules.
Okay, ang ATAF, ma-download rapod sa dito sa website. Nag-open niyo sa dependency.net/reports ang mga tanang template from ATAF 2 to 6 nga inyong nga dawatong sa website dito rapod ma-download.
Another question. From Sir Gerardo Jr. Montilla, later na ang hard copy submit together with the transmittal, Sir Jules?
Again, wala yung ma-change sa ito ang usual process. Kung example, mag-submit mo today. Kung magdala mo og hard copy, mag-submit og hard copy, the same process. Ang nadugang lang na siya ay naka-attach nga akadtong sitawag ni tracking slip, no? Ang usual process na ito, for example, mag-submit ka report dere, magdala ka og mga sample salary claim. The same process, ang nadugang lang na siya ay gapatong nga tracking slip. Or copy lang yapon.
Other questions? Sir Jules, there's a question from our FB Live from Sir Andres Matilia. Sir, good PM. What's the difference of this system to the help desk system?
I think she's referring sa ato document tracking system yapon, no? Sa help desk, mga concerns man ato dito ang makita, no? Kadtong example, na kay mga inquiries nga sa natawag ani sa anak particular office na kay ipang-inquire na kay mga concerns sa help desk to siya. Pero kaning document tracking system, this is for kanang submission sa to ang mga document sa division office, no? Kanang hard copy ng document dito i-submit muna sa tracking system para matrack kung asa na. Katong sa help desk good, kuha mo to dito. Diretso man to sa particular office kung asa ka padulong. For example, mangayo ka og mangayo ka og service record. Automatic help desk man kamo agian na kay dito man kamo log in sa help desk, then select ang service record personal section, then request for service record. Nana siya. Lahi ra sila.
So another sir from FB Live from Ma'am Al-Amis, but I think this has been answered. Ano po yung website para makapag-download po kami ng mga ATA form?
Nasa dito ra po ng website, itong dpdcn.net/reports. Ito ra po dito.
There are no questions, so any queries? Yes, sir, another sir from FB Live again from Antonin. When do we start attaching the DTS code at the document, Sir Julius?
Pwede na karon dayon, ma'am. Pwede na karon dayon kay the system is working na, no? Pwede na karon. Live na system. But katong memo for the policies ana ang mo-follow to siya, ma'am. Pero karon pwede na mo sulay para ang system test po nato, no? Kung unsa iyang kung stable na ba. Pwede na karon.
So, thank you, Sir Jules, and to the participants, you can now ask your questions directly to our presenters here in the platform. Sir Jules, another question from FB Live, from Ma'am Claudia L. Matagba. Ask ko, sir, kana downloaded na ATAF, dili na mag-change sa file name inig-upload na to, dili na ba siya mo override sa nauna nga na-submit?
Okay, thank you, ma'am, sa question, ma'am, no? Dili na siya, ma'am. Dili na. Pero katong previous nga gi-submit nimo, kung the same siya o content sa imong gi-submit go through, ma-override siya. For example, submit kag ATAF 2 karon, and then na isayop siya kung gi-submit di ay na kay changes ato i-change nimo. Pag submit na mag-otro katong previous nimo nga gi submit masapawan to sa imong gi-submit nga bag-o kay di ATAF, no, ang ihang unique niya nga kuan i-detect man niya ang school ID kung sa nga quarter unsa nga learning area. So kung mag-match gani na siya, so meaning pareha to siya nga content, no? So iyatong sapawan. But for the file nga gi-submit, wala problema. Bisag parehag file name tanan, no? Wala rin problema.
Thanks, Sir Jules. Another question from Madeline Villatigon Bungkawil. Sir, good afternoon. What about documents that are to be submitted to the regional office from RDO? Matrack po ba?
Okay, thank you. So, ang tracking tama na sa division office. Makabutang lang dito sa record section sa status sa document, release from the record section to regional office. Nanara, wala pa tayong link sa regional office. Again, ang status niya, released by the record section to ang remarks niya to the regional office. Nanara.
Hello, Ma'am Jekabel. I'm Joy here.
Yes, Ma'am Joy.
Okay, I would like to recognize Ma'am Lilia Abilio, Chief Lilia Abilio. She's raising her hands. Sis, you can have now the platform.
Yes, good afternoon. Thank you so much to the team of the SUD, Ma'am Kington, for recognizing and for seeing my raised hand in the platform. This is just a request from yours truly for our schools, to our schools, and those who are participating now, who are with us in the platform now. My request is that since the ATAF tool is now active, may I request everyone to please start in your utilization of the ATAF tool, because we need the data from your end. And since you are yet to fill in the tool for quarter one, so it's better that you can submit, all the schools will be submitting now their data to us, because after that, you will be submitting quarter two, meaning every quarter you are to fill up the ATAF tool, because we need the data based on what you will be inputting in the ATAF every quarter. So I would like to thank you in advance for your compliance to the required report, which is very important to us for planning data, for policy recommendations for the improvement of curriculum implementation of our in our division. Thank you so much. Thank you, sis, Ma'am Joy Singson.
My pleasure. Always welcome, sis. Another one, I would like to recognize Mrs. Enrita Abrigana, who raised her hand. Ma'am Emmy.
Hello, Ma'am Joy. Good afternoon.
Question, Ma'am Ames.
This is just with regards to the updates. According to Ma'am Lilia Abilio, we will now going to utilize. Actually, Ma'am, we are now in the process of utilizing it. Just today, or yesterday, we started it so that by this time, we can also submit it on time. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you, Ma'am.
Another hand I saw. Thank you, Ma'am Imi. Another hand I saw. I think this is the last hand na. Dayon, baliktas sa questions of Facebook. I saw friend Rigel Bindanyo. PSDS Bindanyo. Take it away. Rigel? Nawala si Ma'am Rigel. Now, go back to Jeka Velarde.
Ma'am, we have a from Ma'am Maria Teresa Baynosa. Ma'am, you can now speak. Hi. Okay, Ma'am Rigel Bindanyo is now in.
Hello po, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, Nosa. Go on.
Hello po, ma'am. Good afternoon po. Putol-putol kasi yung voice, ma'am, para hindi ko masyado marinig. Ask lang po ako, ma'am, if by school ba ang pagpasa ng ATAF, ma'am?
Sir Jules? Po.
Okay, thank you very much. Ang ATAF nga submission, naghansang klase depende sa ATAF form, no? For example, sa ATAF, ito nga niyong isubmit, submit siya, to be accomplished by the subject coordinator. So, by teacher siya, no? So, possible sa inyong school na submit, no? Depende, naman sa form, makita mo niyo kung unsa siya ang klase, kisa mo fill up. Sa ATAF form,
yes, sir.
By school, quarter, dayon, naghani siya. Namay sa memo, nasa memo, makita ninyo dito. Kung kinsa kayo ang...
So, baga, i-download po namin yun, sir. Submit po namin yun.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The accomplishment of the form depende sa klase sa form, but ma'am, no? Nai form nga ang teacher mag-fill up, nai form nga ang subject area coordinator mag-fill up, na-inform nga mag-fill up ang department head, nana siya ma'am, or head teacher, na dito ma'am. Or napoy form nga mag-accomplish is the
school head. Oh.
Thank you ma'am.
Ah, I thought kasi yes, like, consolidation lang yung ipasamin. Ikatong yung school head ng ganit, sir. Ah, so lahat pala ipasa. Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Ma'am Reynosa. And now, Ma'am Reggie, you can now ask your question, ma'am.
Pwede po ka balo sa
Facebook na balik. Sige, go. Sige, go. Facebook.
So, Sir Jules, let's go back to questions from our FB Live from Sir Lizentas Maratas. Aside from ATAC reports, what other report will be submitted through this system?
Thank you. For now, sir, ang ATAF pa lang na ano, some of the tool gi-undergo pa og QA, no? And some po na QA na, gihimuan pa po na mag electronic version. So, ulat-ulat lang tano, ang atong system, ma-update na siya kung naana, and then, of course, na po'y communication para ano siya nga, kung naana'y bagong form na i-submit ninyo. Thank you.
Sir, there's a question here from Ma'am Garnet Mantangan. Good afternoon, Sir Julius. Ask lang ko asa tadapi musulod sa help desk. Ma'am, dito ta musulod sa ato ang .edzn.net. So I think there's no more questions here. Any queries or questions, please just input sa to ang chat box.
So since there are since there's no more questions and queries, I'd like to remind everyone to please, later on, to please kindly answer the Katamin link. I already posted the link on the chat box. And for those who are asking for the presentation, there's also a link there for the presentation. This time, give the platform to give his closing remarks. Marks as well as the ways forward to our Education Program Supervisor of SGOD, Sir Irvi A. Aquilar. Sir?
Thank you so much, Jake. My vow of respect to each and everyone on the platform, my virtual greetings, most especially to the members of the EXICOM, headed by our school superintendent, Ma'am Marianisa Pabilon. Who is this? Says our maninay or godmother in the region, Ma'am Chief Anhao. Our chief, the SGOD, Ma'am Joy. Public school district supervisors, in the platform, school heads around. Participants to this virtual orientation, a quality afternoon to each and everyone once again. So this virtual orientation is very much important, no? Especially during this new normal. These undertakings that we have this afternoon is somewhat 3-in-1. So we are having the document tracking system, the monitoring or performance evaluation mechanism, as thoroughly discussed by chips ending, as well as the electronic monitoring and evaluation system as presented by our division ITO, Sir Julius Pilagantol. So during the presentations, we are reminded that in every program, there will be a specific monitoring tool. Or Sir Inding emphasized that one program, one specific monitoring tool. So like for example, if you are going to monitor Brigada Escuela, so you are going to use also the monitoring tool which is built in the program under Brigada Escuela. Then we are also mandated to use or to utilize the localized monitoring tool. So we can use localized monitoring tool as long as, take note, as long as it is quality assured, or it will be quality assured by the quality assurance team headed by our chief in the School Governance and Operations Division, Ma'am Joy Retransingson. So we are not refrain in using localized monitoring tool in every program that we are having, but we are obliged to submit those monitoring tool for quality assurance. Then in the document tracking system, this is very important, especially during this time that we have no face-to-face in the submission of our documents from your end going to the division office. That is why it is our ITO having this system, the document tracking system, wherein the very basic formula is we have to register first. We have to register in our in the system using our DepEd email. So the system will not accept any email during registration, only the DepEd email, which is controlled by our division, specifically in the office of the ICTO, under Sir Julius Pilagantol. So by doing so, we can really trace, or we can really track the our documents submitted to the division office, and we can follow those documents. Then with the electronic monitoring and evaluation system, as what Sir Julius Smith mentioned, by this time only the ATAP tools are being uploaded in the system. So a time comes that all the activities, all the monitoring reports, all the reports required by our department, it must be downloaded and uploaded on the system, which is the ICTO that Mr. Pilagantol designed. So hopefully this undertakings will be going to go through. This will be a great success of our division, not only because we are aiming for an ISO, but this is for the good of our in the delivery of our services, specifically for our learners and for our teachers. So with that, thank you so much for your participation on this endeavor, this virtual orientation. So hopefully this will be materialized this coming school year 2021-2022, and we can use this even before the end of this school year. So thank you so much. May God bless us all and have a nice day once again.
Okay, thank you so much, Sir Irby. That wraps up everything. But before, I'd like to present the Katamin link as well as the presentation link. Kindly take pictures of this. So thank you everyone and have a good afternoon. Thank you.